I'm Maria, and today I am going to show you how to fix the SSL client authorization signature failed error. Did you try to connect to a server using SSL client certificate authorization only to be met by a message telling you that the SSL client certificate authorization failed? This video will take you through everything you need to know about the SSL client certificate authorization error, including the steps you can take to fix the problem. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what causes the SSL client certificate authorization error? One of the leading causes is some interference in the connection. There are many potential causes within this group, which we'll talk about soon. It could be antivirus software, a VPN, the macOS Keychain Access App, etc. Another common cause is an issue with the TLS version usage, which is the protocol underpinning SSL certificates. There are four versions of TLS: 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3. However, TLS 1.0 and 1.1 have been deprecated as of 2022. In some situations, using a TLS version that's either too low or too high can trigger the SSL client certificate authorization error message. For example, if your smart card only works with TLS 1.2, but the server uses TLS 1.3, that might trigger the error. We're going to start with minor technical fixes and then get into the more technical solutions as we progress. Have you tried turning it on and off again? This tech tip has reached meme status, but it's always a good place to start to rule out any baseline glitches. It definitely won't solve all issues, but it will save you a lot of time if it works. So it's always worth trying before going any further. If you're using an older version of Chrome, that can trigger the SSL client certificate authorization error. Typically, there is an issue with the version of TLS that Chrome is using. To rule out any issues here, make sure that you're using the latest version of Chrome before connecting. In addition to updating Chrome, another baseline troubleshooting step for the SSL client certificate authorization error is to reset Chrome to its default settings. Chrome includes a built-in tool to help you do this. Here's how. Enter the following address in your browser address bar. Scroll down to the bottom of the settings area that appears. Click the Advanced option to expand some additional options. Under the Restore and Cleanup section, click the option to restore settings to their original defaults. Keep in mind, doing this will also remove your saved preferences. If that will cause issues, you'll want to back them up before resetting Chrome. Some firewalls or antivirus software can trigger the SSL client certificate authorization error by interfering with the connection between your computer and the server. This could be your operating system's built-in firewalls or dedicated antivirus software that you've installed. To see if this is the case, try disabling them and testing the connection again. If it works, you can try using different antivirus software or adjusting your software's firewall rules. If you're actively using a VPN while trying to connect, that might cause the SSL client certificate authorization error. If you specifically need the VPN, try disabling the VPN and reconnecting. If you're using macOS, one common cause of the SSL client certificate authorization error is issues with the Keychain Access app. This is the native macOS app that Apple offers to store your passwords and account details, including your SSL client certificates. If this is an issue, you might find that your SSL client certificate still works in Safari, but won't work in other web browsers like Chrome or Firefox. Here's how to fix it. Open the Keychain Access app. Find your SSL client certificate. It should appear under Login, My Certificates. Right-click on the HTTPS private key that's failing. Open the Access Control tab. Select the option to allow all applications to access this item. It might already appear as selected. Even if that's the case, click to select it again. Save your changes. The next time you try to connect to the server that requires client authentication, you should be prompted to enter your keychain password. Do that and then choose Allow Always. The problem should now be fixed going forward. Another common cause of this error is some issue with the TLS version configuration, either because it's too high or too low. The most common issue is that your operating system or smart card reader doesn't work with TLS 1.2 or 1.3. One temporary workaround to fix this is confining your web browser to use TLS 1.1 instead. We do not recommend this as a long-term fix, as it's always better to use modern TLS protocols, especially because TLS 1.0 and 1.1 have been deprecated. However, it might be a viable short-term fix in urgent situations. Here's how to configure Chrome to use an older TLS version. Right-click on the Chrome shortcut on your desktop and select Properties. This is the shortcut that you click to open the Chrome browser. Find the target setting in the Shortcut tab, which should be open by default. Add the following text outside of the existing target. Click OK to save your changes. When you open Chrome using that shortcut, it will now use that TLS version. In Firefox, you can change the TLS version configuration in Firefox's settings. Open Firefox, enter About Config in the browser address bar. Search for TLS. Adjust Security TLS version min and Security TLS version max according to your preferences. We've already talked about how you can try to fix this error by changing the TLS version that your browser uses. However, if you have access to the server, you also might be able to fix specific issues by adjusting the server configuration. For example, if you're storing the SSL client certificate on a smart card reader, some smart card readers will only work with TLS version 1.2. To fix this, you can try playing around with the server configuration. For example, one user initially had their server configured to use TLS minimum version 1.0 and was able to fix the error by adding another flag to the set the max version to 1.2. One final troubleshooting tip is to update the Windows software if all else fails. Often, the SSL client certificate authorization error results from older versions of Windows. If possible, update your systems to the latest version, or at least a more modern version. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.